Hi, this is Raksil and welcome back to the channel. And in this video, we are going to install this latest Corvus OS vS2.1 Revolt Official Android 12L. And before we start the video, if you haven't subscribed the channel, then please go and subscribe the channel and also turn on the notification bell to get notified whenever I post new video in the future. All right, let's get going. We say goodbye, you won't forget about me, right? And there are many chance lock. This is a huge chance lock here. Okay, so here are the screenshot. Now let's go and flash this custom ROM. Let's boot into custom recovery and then start flashing. These are the files you need. You need Android 11 firmware and the Corvus ROM. This is the GApps build. And I also have 8.12 disable force encryption because I am decrypted user. But if you are encrypted user, then you don't need 8.12 disable force encryption. But if you are encrypted, then you will need to format your data and then copy these files from your PC or pen drives, then start flashing. Okay, now let's go and wipe Dalvik cache system vendor data. Swipe to wipe. Now let's go back to files and select the Android 11 firmware. Add to queue. Select the Corvus ROM. GApps build. Add to queue. And you can swipe to install if you are encrypted user. But if you are decrypted user, then select disable force encryption. Then swipe to install. Now this will take a few minutes to get installed, so please be patient. Don't do anything with your phone, don't switch off, or don't try to cancel this installation, or this might hard brick or soft brick your phone. So please be careful while installing any custom ROM. Okay, that's a pretty good advice for you. Okay, so just be patient. Let's wait for the complete installation. Okay, it's done. Now just reboot into system and see how the ROM is. Okay. Blue, pink, Corvus. Wow, the boot animation is so freaking awesome. Get started. Android version is 12L, Android 12L, and the kernel is PSSG performance. SE Linux is enforcing, and the security patch is 5th April 2022. That is good. Now we go to system gesture, and in gestures you get swipe to screenshot, three finger. It's working, and you have enable advanced restart option here. Okay, you have for system recovery bootloader and system UI, right? Now let's go to Corvus setting, and you have tons of customization here. You get theming, status bar, quick settings, lock screens, battery optimization, customization, and notification like heads up, notification lights, and miscellaneous. You have unlimited Google Photos storage. Spoof your device as Pixel XL for Google Photos F only to provide unlimited storage for backup. Great, that is great. And you can unlock higher FPS in games. You get these options. This is great. And let's go to, and in Play Store you get device is certified out of the box. Now let's check DRM info. Now let's see the DRM info. Wideband CDM, security level L1. Okay, that is great. So in the home settings, you get quick step launcher, lock, layout, icons and widgets can be added, removed and moved on the home screen. You have Google search bar, you can turn on off. Theme icons, swipe to access Google app, and you have developer option. And on the left side in your home screen, you get this Google Fit. Okay, it's not that smooth, but it's smooth. This is 60 hertz display. And in wallpapers and style, you get Raven walls. These are the Corvus wallpapers. Let's see the Antutu benchmark. This is the Antutu benchmark score, 522333. That is impressive. Not so good, not so bad. It's average score. Now in Geekbench, here we have average score. Single score is 733 and the multi score is 2588. You get very basic camera here in this custom ROM, but I have installed ANX camera in this custom ROM and it's working. Everything is working. Pro mode, video, photo, portrait, 48 megapixel, it's working. Okay, you can install this ANX camera. You can watch the video from the link in the description. I have made a particular video how to install ANX camera in your Redmi K20 Pro for Android 12 or Android 12L. We don't have much to see here, but yeah, this custom ROM is good for gaming. And let's see the Corvus Gen. The Corvus Gen is now on, but this Gen mode is not like OnePlus. You can disable this, right? And you can see the fingerprint is fast and smooth. It's butter smooth. Okay, that's pretty much it for this video, and thanks for watching. If you enjoy watching this type of content like custom ROM review, custom ROM installation for your Redmi K20 Pro, then please consider subscribing the channel and turn on the notification bell to get notified whenever I post new video in the future. Peace out. Goodbye. Even when we say goodbye, you won't forget about me.